Yo, what's going on guys, I'm back with another video and today I am back on my own server Immortal, where I'll be going over some of the latest updates like I did in my last few videos. Anyways, last update log that we did earlier this week was a huge update log, so I'll go over all of them in just a second. But before that, I want to announce two things. Starting off, if you go to the forums, you can actually scroll down. And as you can see in the event section, there is the YouTube event, which is still going on. The YouTube event will end at the 1st of April. So this is in like a week. So definitely make sure to still enter while you have the chance. You can win three things. At the first place, you can win a Draeger set of choice, plus an automatic loot banker, plus lead donator rank. On the second place, you will win a Twisted Bow Lead Donator rank. And on the third place, you will win a Lead Donator rank and 5 Ultra Rare Mystery Boxes. This totals up to over $400 of rewards. So definitely make sure you enter, because even if you have no subscribers, you still have a chance of winning these items. Now, the second thing I want to announce real quick is the RSPS community Discord owned by Kai. Now, Kai is a very nice guy. He has given me the owner rank and he will also be posting some of my videos on his channel. So if you are looking to this video from his channel, definitely make sure to join Immortal as well. And definitely make sure to subscribe to my channel as well. Anyways, if you want to join this Discord, the link is down below in the description. It is a community Discord, so you have a bunch of different servers, YouTubers and all that good stuff in the chat. So definitely make sure you enter the Discord for a lot of interaction and a lot of fun. Anyways, going over the updates, I first want to announce that Johnny is now a full-time developer. He was doing part-time development in the past, but now he's a full-time developer, so updates will be coming more frequently and we will be doing a lot more big updates as well. Starting off, I fixed the Cyrenic models, equip and inventory models. So as you can see, it's now fully and it's not buggy anymore like it used to be. I also added the blood dye with the code for the blood dyed Cyrenic. Now this is unavailable at the moment because I still need to get some other models done. But once those are all done, we will be able to release the blood dye as well. We also fully added the 99 plus skilling zone, where we have a few things already placed. Not all skills are already 99 plus, but we can already go to the 99 plus skilling zone to chop ourselves 5 different types of logs, which I went over in the last update log. But you can also burn the logs, you can also fletch them into unstrung bows, and then when you string them, they will be even more money worth. So these are definitely really nice if you want to do some AFK money making. Now when I get more models for the 99 plus skills, I will release more 99 plus skilling content. Also, there is a 99 plus slayer portal which has been added at the 99 plus skilling zone, which will teleport you to the Gilded Dragons. That are still being worked on 4 other new 99 plus slayer NPCs, but let's go ahead and teleport to the 99 plus skilling zone so far. So as you can see, if you just run over there, you have the trees, but let's go through the portal and let's go to the Gilded Dragons, because the Gilded Dragons have 2 new custom drops. Well, actually 3. If you examine it, you can actually see that the Gilded Dragon will now drop the Corrupted Scimitar and the Offhand Corrupted Scimitar, also the Demonic Hireloom Crystal, which I'll go over in a second. Now the Corrupted Scimitars are actually to bridge the gap between the PVM Whip and the Draegers, which was a pretty big. So with these scimitars, which will be decently cheap but not the cheapest, you will have yourself some nice weapons as well. Now scrolling down a bit more, Run is now being saved if you relog. There is a build store added to the skilling zone, so where you can buy stuff with build bags. Ascension crossbows now work the similar way as Draegers. You need both main hand and off hand, and then they will actually hit double instead of being able to hit double with just the main hand. They are also available in the donation store now. There is also a new custom mystery box, which is the cosmetic box, so I will just spawn them in real quick. Let's open up 10 and see what we can get. And as you can see, there are a bunch of new customs that are made by Mike, so a huge thank you to Mike. We also got a party hat set from this, but Sky Party Hat, Ghost Halloween, Black Halloween, another ghost, so we didn't get that much customs. But if we scroll down a bit more, there is almost 100% chance of receiving a cosmetic from these new boxes. These are also available in the donation store. There's also a new custom grinding zone, which I'll go over real quick. At home, you can talk to Party Pete, Party Pete will then teleport you to the new cosmetic zone, and the cosmetic zone will then have two NPCs that you can grind out, which will be another Party Pete, and there will be also some Party Girls. So as you can see, Party Pete will drop the Halloween masks, he will drop the cosmetic mystery box, and then he will drop all recolored Halloween masks, but he also drops the black party Halloween masks and the demonic masks, which look pretty dope. Then you have the Party Goat. He will actually drop all the party hats and Santa hats. As you can see, there are a bunch of different Santa hats. You also have textured Santa hats right here, so those are even more rare. But if you can get your hands on those will look really nice as well. Now let's go over the demonic Hireloom. Now this is where you will need the demonic crystals for. Anyways, the Demonic Hireloom is now available from level 1 to 10. It's also available in the donation store, however this is quite an expensive piece of equipment that you can buy. But you can also craft it in-game by combining an attacker level 5, healer level 5, defender level 5, a collector level 5 and 500 billion cash. Now the Demonic Crystal level 1 is just combined of all the 4 level 5s. From there on you can upgrade it just to get it better. You can upgrade the Demonic Hireloom with the Demonic Crystals, which are also available in the donation store, but you can also get them from the 99 plus Slayer monsters. Now in total you will need about 171 Demonic Crystal Gems to get the max level Demonic Hireloom, which is quite expensive and quite rare to get, so it's definitely a big grind until you will be the max level Demonic Hireloom, but it's definitely worth it because you will get a 7.5% bonus drop rate if you have the max level. All the drop rates are in a link which you can click once you read this topic, which I'll link down below in the description as well. And now you can also get the demonic crystals from the donated box, super mystery box and ultra rare mystery box. They were added to the box as well. Also the Well of Goodwill is added to the home area. Now this is quite nice because this is something that will benefit the whole server. This is meant as a money sink, so you can donate cash. Once 200 billion cash total is donated, which I'll do in just a second. Alright, so I'm just using one of the players account that allowed me to do this for the video. Now as you can see, if you donate to the well, you type 200 bill cash. With 200 bill, the Well of Goodwill will now be activated for the whole server. So the whole server now has double experience for 4 hours and a 0.50% bonus drop rate for 4 hours, which is very nice. Now all players will be benefiting from this. Also, 200 bill cash gets removed from the economy every time this well gets activated. So that is super nice as well. Now the well does, however, require a client update. So if you don't have the latest client already, definitely make sure to download it on the website. There is also a link in the Discord where you can download the client. So definitely make sure you have the latest client as well. Now we also added a teleport when you click on your skill in the skilling tab. This also requires the latest client. Now this is something that used to lag if you clicked on the skills, but now you can actually teleport to the training location. So that is a lot nicer than how it used to be, and you'll be teleported right next to the shop and right next to the closest thing that will help you out with that skill. For the rest, the new Slayer NPC was the Gilded Dragons. You do require 102 Slayer to actually kill the Gilded Dragons, but then again the drops that it drops, I already went over it. We also removed the Mugger from home because it automatically attacked new players and it would bug them out when they created an account, so that is now removed. Now for the rest, a few fixes. There was a dupe with presets that has been fixed. There was also a problem with the preset loading which has been fixed. There was also a problem that you couldn't damage next. Now that has also been fixed. The Revenant's drop table has been fixed. The Gnome agility course was buggy as well. That also has been completely fixed. Instances were fixed for the Corporal Beast, Calphite Queen, Blue Jet and Viruago. The other instances were working fine, these just had an issue, but this has been fixed with this update as well. Now in the next update we will be working on finishing the achievements and having a new custom launcher, so you don't have to download a new client when we have to, a client update, the launcher will automatically do that for you. What's coming soon is the Treasure Island minigame. We will have more 99 plus Slayer NPCs which will be custom to our server and fully custom armors as well. Now, I hope you guys did enjoy this small update video. I will actually be giving away 5 of these cosmetic mystery boxes, which are $20 each in the donation store, so that's a $100 giveaway. Anyways, all you have to do to enter the giveaway is make sure you are subscribed, make sure you comment your in-game name, the notifications are turned on, and make sure you like the video as well. If all that is done, you have a chance of winning this cosmetic mystery box, and you might be lucky and get a super rare item from it as well, which will be pretty dope. Anyways, if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to smash the like button, subscribe if you didn't already, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.